Hello everyone, we're hope you're doing all right. We wanted to show you this little emergency ammo can radio we built. You know, with everything going on today, it's never a bad idea to have options for alternate communication. We just want to give you a few disclaimers before we get into this. One, this channel is not monetized. So we're going to have all the links in the description below. If you guys want to build this radio or help support this channel, please use the links to our Amazon store. It doesn't cost you guys anything, and Amazon just throws us a couple pennies for every purchase that's sold with our link. So that's that spiel about the channel. Into the radio. To operate this radio that we built, you're going to have some type of license. Amateur radio license would be best. This is basically a 50 caliber ammo can. You can find them anywhere. M2A1 50 cal can. So what we set out to do is make a radio that could communicate across multiple bands and receive across multiple bands. It had to meet some cornerstones. It had to be light enough to carry, you know, in case you had to move it. So this is about 18 pounds fully loaded all in. So, you know, it's not too heavy. It had to be durable and rugged. So it's inside this waterproof ammo can box. And we do have some foam and felt bumpers in there to protect things from jarring around. And it had to be simple to use so that if you opened it up, there's no instructions really in there how to use it, but there are some helpful things and there are pre-set up channels on there in order for you to get on the air in an emergency. Again, this is an emergency radio. This is not for use every day. We're gonna dust it off once or twice a year just to test it, and that's all it's gonna be. So we'll open it up and get into showing you exactly how we did it. All right, there's the radio open. It can work in this configuration exactly like this setup. No issues once all the wires are pulled out and set up. What we're gonna do is just separate this top half from here. It just slides right off. All right, on the lid up here, we basically show exactly what the radio can do. AM, FM, NOAA, 2 meters, 1.25 meters, and 70 centimeters. BTECH sells different amplifiers for different type of ranges. So whatever suits your needs, you can probably find it on Amazon or wherever. Down here at the bottom, we have the national call in frequencies of 2 meter, 1.25, and 70 centimeters. Just as a quick reference, just in case anybody gets in this radio and needs to operate it. So that's the top lid right there. Not so much going on there. And it can, like I said, it can hang out on the ammo can. On the back here, what we did was we ended up changing out the SMA or getting an adapter to a BNC just for easy connection so we don't wear anything out. And then we got a 90 degree to a BNC for the antenna up there. So that's just the top lid. We'll get inside of it now. All right, in here we got some more quick reference cards that just lay in there. And this is gonna be the most common frequencies. You guys can find this online, it's real easy. And we just laminated it. That's one card, and then over here, that's an antenna. We got the amateur radio bands right here. Again, you can find all this stuff online. Just some quick reference cards, GMRS channels, just so you have something, you know, to refresh your memory in case you forgot all that. Inside here is really where everything's going on, honestly. And we'll try and get a good angle to show you guys. So we just have everything laid out in here. By the luck of the draw, everything lays out perfectly every time we've had it open a few times. We'll get everything laid out and show you what we got in here. All right, these are a bunch of stuff that's removable from the can. We're just using a little Triband RM5 Baofeng, or Baofeng, however you want to pronounce it. It's a pretty decent radio. It's got USB-C charging capability, and that's why we did it, so that we can charge it off the ammo can. And then again, we just converted that SMA connection to a BNC for a quick disconnect. Standard PTT microphone. We do have the option for the tri-band antenna here, and we can remove this VNC connector and put the tri-band on there in case we have to go mobile with the HT. Otherwise, it'll serve as the base station here. This is the normal antenna we use with the entire base station. It's an Abree, I think 42-inch tactical. We did a little rat tail on there. This actually works really well, this antenna. So no complaints there. We haven't checked the SWR rating. Again, this is an emergency radio, so we really didn't care about the SWR rating since all these pieces are changeable and pretty much expendable. I mean, these little radios are super cheap. This is gonna be all the connections for power and communication here. And if you see, we got a whole bunch of these ferrite chokes on here. And the reason that's on there is because when this radio is on in conjunction with the batteries and everything and the little buck converter we got in there, you get a lot of noise in the background, electronic noise. And we started the test and choke out one by one, and finally we got a clear signal. And this is what we ended up with. You know, a couple wraps on there, and that's the K1 style connection into the amp. That is our signal wire coming from the top of the radio into the amp. And this is the power wire for the amp because one, it was long and it goes all around when it's plugged in down there. So we choked it out pretty well. And, you know, they say about 7 of these chokes are good. So we got 2, 4, 6 on there. We just didn't have enough to do it, but it ended up working out great. So we'll go into the can now and check it out. Now inside the can here is where things get interesting. So if you see, most people will run your batteries. These are 12 volt lithium batteries. These are 10 amp hours each. They're in parallel. So it's running 20 amp hours at 12 volts. Well, most amplifiers, most base stations, most type of radios, they run off about 13.5, 13.9, you know, what car voltage runs off of. So we started to see in some experimenting that without a buck converter like this, you start to get some distortion or whatever you want to call it, signal loss, just because as you're pulling down amperage out of the battery, the voltage is lowering, and thus the output of the amplifier and the radio itself, if everything is plugged in, was going down, at least what we were seeing. So to rectify that, we ended up getting this little buck converter here. And if you see, it's an input of 80 to 40 volts DC, and the output is 12.8 volts constant at 25 amps. So this thing will put out exactly what a car alternator is putting out and keep that voltage strong and at 13.8, 13.9. Basically 345 watts is what you can pull out of this, more than enough to charge and transmit. Everything's fully fused down here. Everything is on marine switches. So I'll turn it around here so you can see. Basically, if a fuse goes out inside this fuse section here, it will illuminate. And that right there is not strobing or pulsing, it's LEDs. But as you can see, it's 13.9 volts. Down here, we got USB-C. QD, PD, all that. We got 12 volts here and then our toggle switch. And again, everything else is choked out down there. This can also be charged AC and DC. We have a SAE connector in here that goes right into the batteries. So it's solar charging. It's very versatile. We're gonna get it all hooked up and get it together and show you how it looks. All right, here we are all set up. And if you hear somebody's coming through, we're just listening right now. I'm just turn it up so you guys can hear it.
Hey, zero, okay, back clear.
All right, everybody, as you've seen, the radio 100% works. It will transmit and receive. We got just this big antenna sitting outside, so we don't have stress on the back there. But we'll just recap on everything real quick in case we miss anything through the video, because we really want everybody to have this experience and to have an additional line of communication with your family at least, and your friends. Because when the internet goes down and the cell service goes down, guess what? This still works. So we have our quick reference cards here. You can find these all online very easily. We have a Triband Nagoya antenna here. That's if we want to remove the HT and take it out, because we have another HT as well, just like this, so that we can set up a mobile base station. We have the 42-inch Abri tactical antenna with a homemade rat tail on there. That has really improved the reception a lot. So we have a 50 cal ammo can here, very simple. We have a BTECH amplifier, again with the national calling frequencies and what we can do there. This is just a small BNC coax cable that is a coax to BNC 90, a whole bunch of ferrite chokes, and you're gonna have to find your own combination. Down there, we have the DC to DC converter, which is a 375 watt one. It will maintain that 13.9 at 25 amps. We got a 5RM tri-band Baofeng radio there. With all the connections, an automotive type marine fuse holder, just regular blade standard fuse holder. These are two LiPo 10 amp hour batteries. They're run in parallel so that we have 20 amp hours at 12.6 volts, which then goes into here and it steps it up to that 13.9. This again is a marine rocker switch that you can find on Amazon. They come pre-built. We built this one to have the amp meter and everything in there. That's your 12 volt cigarette lighter. And down here is just your standard socket for USB-C and USB-A 3.0 and QC and PD 60 watts out, which is why we have this big buck converter here. We kind of oversized everything so that the system does not stress itself, because this thing has to be able to survive getting beat up out there and thrown around, because it is an emergency radio. Other than that, it's really simple to wire. You know, you're just running your parallel wiring. Everything is fused, but it's simple 12 volt connections, very easy to do. If there is more interest in this video and enough likes and comments, and you guys really want to see a breakdown of another one, we will build a different one, a smaller version that may just be as good. So I hope this helps you guys out there. If you like it, smash that like button, subscribe, comment, share the video. The more it gets out there, the more people can get on the air and enjoy this. Until next time, thanks for watching. Please subscribe.